Everybody, Travis Nader here once again. We are back with The Wolf Among Us, episode 4, in sheep's clothing. Last time we left off, well, I'm sure it'll give us a little bit of a sneak peek. Haha. It's as simple as that. Do you have any idea how much it costs to have fucking Mr. Toad. Toad is a bitch.
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing.
He's a big bitch. Crane must have taken a shot. Open arms. Crane fucking stole our shit, man. Stay.
Thanks, Bigby.
Oh, thanks.
And thanks for covering for me last time, too.
Bigby? How did you do this to me?
I guess I finally see you for who you are. Tell me who did it. Just
dude, calm down.
Oh, you know.
I don't think he did it.
Ichabod Crane is a fucking hopeless, creepy fucking prick. Murdered these women? Oh, yeah, and then the fucking action began. They're like, oh, we fucking killed Bigby. He's dead. And then Bigby's like, yeah, fuck no. I ain't dead till I fucking say I'm dead. Fucking killed Tweedledum. And then I got fucking shot.
But, you know.
By fucking Bloody Mary.
Okay? Take Crane.
Fucking Crane, you fucking piece of shit.
A beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really. I mean it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen.
Fucking crazy bitch. Oh, man. PlayStation, shut up. Stop beeping. Holy shit. Shut up. Oh my god, what the fuck is going on? What? Oh, that blood dude. Oh no. Oh no. It's Bloody Mary. Oh! Fucking nightmares, dude.
Coin bullets are a nasty business. The silver slug deformed and shredded on impact.
Oh fuck.
He'll be okay.
Pull it all out. Hmm?
He'll be okay?
His internal organs are positively riddled. If I don't extract every single scrap of silver, he's liable to suffer some long-term toxicosis.
Hey.
Easy there. Try not to move.
And Bigby will fucking die. Oh, man.
Bigby.
Fuck.
We can't keep me.
I wish she did to my fucking arm.
I figured I'd be done before you were conscious.
Sorry, oh, bitch.
How bad is it?
Well, not the worst I've seen, but damn near it. I must say, you're testing even my skills here.
I'm sorry. It's fun.
Please,
oh my god, Jesus Christ.
Doctor.
Look, I'm a bit engaged saving his life at the moment. But if the fractured extremity concerns him that much, he can set it himself.
Dude, his fucking bone is oh my god. Dude, his fucking arm is like, the bone is broken completely. Like, how the fuck do you put this back together? Oh. Oh. Oh my god, dude, but like. Oh. Oh, this is so fucking, like, even, you know, it's like fucking not even like real. Like, it's animated. It's still fucking, oh. Oh my god, he got it back together. Somehow, I don't know how that works.
Hmm. Not bad. That'll do, I suppose.
Oh, fuck.
He'll be alive.
Fuck.
Maybe next time, if he keeps going like this. He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll
listen
to
you. Oh my god. I'm a big bad wolf, I gotta kill people.
Well, he should.
It's not like I...
Yeah, he didn't ask to get shot, to be honest.
It's not like you actively discouraged it either.
That's true. That's a fair point. When I saw her pull up the gun, I should have been just like, okay,
excuse
calm
me,
down.
Miss White, but perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
Oh, man.
I think I should stay. At least until he's out of the woods.
Believe me, Bigby couldn't be in better hands. And I need the space to work, so...
Stick around, all right? I don't know if I trust this guy.
Please, I can do this with my optic nerve severed. We'll be done in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
Colin.
Hey, Doc, how much longer?
What's going on, Colin?
Leave him be.
It's finished when it's finished.
Because I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin, you're not even supposed to be here right now.
Oh, really? Where am I supposed to be? I'm here to take care of my friend.
Could you please not distract the doctor while he has my chest cut?
Be on the farm, you fucking pig.
Yes, that would be helpful.
Fuck, just pull me there.
All done.
Damn.
Great.
This is
bandage me up and fucking
having visits with me.
And,
well, this time.
That was fast.
This time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue. Miss White.
Fuck.
He'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
Oh my god.
He knows what it means. It's just been an unusual couple of days.
Yeah, we've been busy.
But please, don't give him the excuse. His body will eventually give out. Take care of him. Please.
It's up to Bigby what he wants to fucking do.
He'll need rest, I assume.
Sleep mostly. Just keep watch.
Snow has enough to deal with, Swinehart. Yeah. I can take care of myself.
Just clearly fucking lay here and do.
Anyways, start against, as they say. Miss White, Sheriff, Colin.
It doesn't like fucking Colin. Oh my god. Fucking crazy. Fucking crazy! He goes and grabs like a beer.
So, how do you, feel?
Oh, I feel fucking groovy.
It's Bigby, Snow. He'll be okay. Hell, I've seen him take worse.
How do you think I feel? Like shit.
You should see how you look.
Shut up, Colin. Nobody asked for your fucking comments. Oh, fucking Colin.
You stopped breathing, you know.
Oh, shit.
When you passed out or died.
Yeah, I died for a bit. Oh.
It kind of scared the hell out of me.
Well, yeah, you watched one fucking die right in front of you. Yeah, like, and you watched.
I've seen you like that. And when
you watched fucking Tweedledum get his throat ripped out, and then you watched me practically die. It's fucking crazy, imagine.
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong way.
Colin.
Shut up, Colin.
I'm just saying, I was worried about him is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
Well, I'll get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing? What's even happening out there? I mean, do you guys have like a plan or something?
This guy lives in an apartment and doesn't leave at all.
Should I be asking? Should I be worried about the crooked man taking over?
Snow's maybe the boss. She'll know what's best for the community.
Thanks. The crooked man came out of the shadows for a reason. For him
that
to attack us so blatantly like that. He either feels invincible or desperate.
Well, I'm gonna say he's fucking desperate. I don't think I'd pick desperate.
What do you mean?
You traded Crane to save Bigby. I'm just saying. That's not exactly something you do when you're playing with house money.
So he called my bluff. It's not like I'm gonna let Bloody Mary just murder
him. Yeah. Thanks, Snow. For all that back there.
Yeah.
No problem.
Thanks? You're not pissed that Crane's flown the coop?
Crane the fucking bitch.
Or that the crooked man thinks he's got Snow under his thumb.
What else could Snow do?
What else could Ichabod? Ichabod Crane is useless.
Crane still would have been taken.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll take your word for it.
Exactly. All I care about right now is just what does the crooked man want out of this? I thought he was just a loan shark, but clearly he's operating in other circles.
He sounds like a kind of loan shark kind of person. Right?
Getting him out of town? Is this all about the murders? Crane can't be useful to him anymore. So what could this have to do with Faith and Lily?
Crane was a puppet, and the crooked man worked the strings. This is all about control of Fabled Town.
Mm-hmm. But then what do prostitutes have to do with it? Lily?
Maybe they saw stuff that...
I don't know.
Maybe
how
they saw stuff that wasn't supposed to
I know it does
be seen?
Somehow.
Oh.
The crooked man. declared war against us last night.
Damn fucking right he did.
At least that's what I thought when it happened. But now I see this war has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken.
Ooh.
We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean, the right way?
Not fucking rip people's throats.
I don't know, but it suspiciously sounds like your way. Bigby's the one on the front lines.
I know things haven't gone great recently, but we're still doing our best.
That's not good enough.
Ooh. We gotta stop.
So,
I gotta stop ripping people's throats out.
We do everything cut and dried, by the book, straight as an arrow.
Pure as driven snow.
I'm not saying I'm the arbiter of...
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen.
No, otherwise I fucking... Otherwise
we need
maybe
monsters.
Guys.
The fight monsters.
Colin, if I really believed that we needed him to lose his flippin' mind at a moment's notice...
I'll do better. We'll do better. We have to.
I have to do better, though.
What's the point?
Right,
otherwise,
exactly.
I'm gonna get killed.
Thank you.
And Colin's gonna get sent to the farm.
I'm sorry that I
and
have to.
Actually, everyone's gonna
up,
fucking die, probably.
I think it's important. Look, Bigby, I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy. Everybody wants Bigby to smile.
He's not.
He's
not wrong.
Take a shower now and then.
Relax, Colin.
He's Colin's not wrong.
Myself, okay.
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to. I'm going to let you do it, okay? It's just that now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect.
Colin's like fuck you.
Has to
Colin's
end.
Like
what
fuck
situation?
You.
All unglamored fables starting today have to
oh,
go and stay at the...
Oh, give me a fucking break.
Fuck.
Are you gonna let her talk to me like that?
It's been the rule for a reason, Colin. And Bigby knows it's for the best of the town. It keeps everybody out of trouble.
And what if a Mundy does see me, huh? I'm a pig, not a mouse with a hat and a cane.
She's in charge, man.
Says that's the way it's gotta be.
Snow's in charge,
what?
You gotta do what?
Are you kidding me?
If you would simply get a glamour.
Get a glamour? With what money? You think I can work? I don't even have thumbs.
Colin, we'll buy you a fucking glamour.
Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Buffkin, what is it?
Okay, fucking buy you one.
I'll let him know. Thanks.
How about that?
Guess who's waiting in your office right now?
Oh, no.
Narissa.
Narissa?
Oh.
That broad from the pudding and pie?
Okay, not
yes.
Who I was thinking.
Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you. What
Ooh.
Do you think that could be?
Bigby's got an admirer. You always do well with the, disenfranchised.
She knows something. She's helped me a little with the case. Maybe she has something else.
Yeah.
Maybe she does. I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long.
He's probably fucking drinking. That alcoholic.
And I should probably change out of these clothes. Consider the discussion tabled,
yep.
But not over. Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain. She's a piece of work. Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you? I mean,
oh, fuck,
she seemed real serious about it, but I can still hang out here, right?
I don't know. Snow will come around. She's just... Well, the crane thing hit her hard.
Very stressed.
She doesn't really know who her friends are right now.
Oh, okay. I get it.
Don't worry about it.
Thanks, Bigby.
Fucking hope he doesn't get sent to the farm. I like him just hanging out in my my penthouse suite over here. Oh god. Simpler times. I forgot we live in the building that where his office is. It's kind of weird. Yeah. Yo, what's going on? Just fucking waiting in my office, creepster. Fucking creepster. Fucking prostitute creepster. Oh, what the fuck? The game like froze there for a second. I was like, please, don't do it now. Don't fucking freeze now. The Awful Mongols, episode 4, in sheep's clothing. We are here to stop some shit. Ba-da-ba-ba-da-da. Ba-da-ba-ba-da. Episode 4. In sheep's clothing. Hello, prostitute. Hi. Lady. She's like, I've been waiting a long time for you. And you're like, why'd your voice change? She's like, I've been waiting for you, Big B. I've been waiting to give you a good time. And you're like, what the
have
fuck?
A seat.
Oh, gosh. Fucking look at this guy, alcoholic. Drinks everywhere. He's like, fuck, I don't want to do this right now. Oh, Jesus Christ. What do you have to tell me?
Are you okay?
Kind of.
You didn't look good last night. I wasn't sure you'd be...
Let's just say I've been better.
Fucking coughing my lungs up. Yeah, I fucking starts coughing because of smoking, so he just lights up another smoke.
Huffin' puffs. Not many people smoke those.
Interesting. Are Huffin' Puffs fucking like a shit brand or something?
Thanks.
So what is it you wanted to talk to me about?
Look at your cigarettes. Jesus Christ.
Sending me to the open arms. I think you want to help me again.
There's not a lot that I can talk about. You know that.
So yes. That spell Crane was trying to break. It's not just while you're at work, huh?
What I mean is, I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want you wasting your own time either.
Back in the dressing room, at the pudding and pie, I told you what I was looking for, and you found a way to tell me. You sent me to the open arms. Maybe that'll work again?
Maybe.
You know. Can try. I just...
These lips are sealed.
Might work.
Is there more to this business with Crane? You gave me the key to room 204. You put me on to Crane. Is there something I'm missing here?
These lips are sealed.
God damn it.
If I could answer you just like that, I wouldn't have had to make that appointment with you.
No, I guess not.
So I have to ask her in a specific way that she'll give the answer?
We have to find our way through life. Maybe. On our own, grasping and fumbling in the dark.
Okay.
I used to have friends to help me find my way, but now they're gone, and I don't know what to do.
Are you saying you need a friend right now? You can trust me.
What I'm saying is friends matter. And I don't have any left. So I hope you're looking after yours.
Okay.
Are you? Look around you.
It's my job to look out for people.
Okay.
And not just
so keep my friends.
I'm sorry.
God damn it.
I thought I could do this. I need you to know, I want to help, but...
These lips are sealed.
But your lips are sealed.
Fuck.
I'm sorry if I'm wasting your time.
Much kind of like...
I thought I knew how to say it.
Ribbons.
Oh.
Faith wore one too.
Do you like it? Do you?
How can I? It's a tool to keep you stuck in that life. Subservient. That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
Oh, no. You can say, take the ribbon off? Oh, no. What, is that going to accomplish anything? I have no idea. Uh-oh.
Can't we just take the ribbon off?
Ooh.
No! His lips are sealed!
What?
You can't! Just stay back!
Wouldn't that help, though?
Do that!
Slow down. It's all right. I'm not gonna do anything.
I didn't know he was gonna reach
Please.
And...
Don't.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's get the shit out of her.
So the ribbons, if you take them off...
What happened? Did you just, like, die? It's like her fucking... If she takes the ribbon off, does her just body just fucking explode? I'm confused. Oh. Why is she, like, fucking...
I came here.
What? What the fuck? Calm down. Snow. Take
Listen,
it easy.
Sheriff.
Oh.
Can you keep this conversation between us?
Absolutely.
I could be in a lot of trouble.
I won't tell anyone, don't worry.
It's not like you fucking told me much, so it's like... Oh! Oh!
I just need to talk to the sheriff for a moment. Please excuse us.
It's not what you think it is. Like fucking mean Beauty.
For you, but I don't know how solid it is. Beauty and Beast called the office just now.
Oh.
They said they wanted to talk to you about something.
Oh no.
I wonder if they've heard about Crane. Thank you for listening, Sheriff. You should go on to your next business. I don't think you'll be wasting your time. Wait, you don't have to go.
No. Okay, so that's the hint right there.
That was. Abrupt?
It's one way to send a message.
She did send a message there.
What did she tell you? They didn't mean to rush you. Did you get anything from her?
She couldn't really say anything. The magic that Crane was talking about, it's in the ribbon.
And you can't take the ribbon off?
Nope.
Or...
It's how Faith and Lily died.
Oh.
Okay then. Good work. So, about Beauty and Beast, do you think there's something to it? Is this the right place to look? What could they know about the Crooked Man? Or do you think they just heard about last night, and they're scared about what's been going on?
That's what Narissa was doing. Telling us to go there. I think she made it as clear as she could have.
Yeah. She's like, go talk to them. They're not wasting your time. You just lit the cigarette and you fucking put it out already?
She was looking for financial assistance.
Yes.
I told her there was nothing I could do, and she said that meant she'd have to go somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
Bigby, you don't think she meant that she was going to go to the Crooked Man, do you?
And would explain why they called.
Exactly.
We need to solve this before something else happens. Who knows what?
She's paranoid because she doesn't pay them back to... Crooked Man's gonna.
I have other matters to attend to.
Get people to kill her. Or get Bloody Mary to fucking kill her. I hope not, but you know. Wow, she just left me so abruptly at the elevator. It's like, oh. Okay, well, I gotta go now. See you later. Okay.
And you didn't want to tell me what you were into either.
Good reason. Look what happened.
So that's back on me now.
Hold on, before there's. Oh, you can't go any further. Okay.
You said it was. That doesn't mean I...
Hello.
Oh. What do you want?
You fucking wanted to see me.
Well, you're just going around knocking on doors? Stirring the pot?
Snow sent me. Said you wanted to talk.
Not
Damn
me.
Right.
Listen, I've had a shitty night.
Do you think you're the only one?
And I really don't want to deal with the runaround. Snow said you called and wanted
Damn
to
right.
talk to me.
Well, I didn't call. Must have been Beauty. She's been surprising me a lot lately.
Can I?
So have you, Bigby.
Oh my
Yet
god.
With all the sneaking around and secrets, somehow I'm still the bad guy.
You know, because I'm not fucking doing anything with your wife.
I hear about it all night long.
Bigby's not doing anything with your wife. I don't know why you think she is.
Who's there?
You don't want
it's fucking
talk.
Me. It's
Can
fucking
you just
Bigby.
Get for me?
I don't know. Is it safe to turn my back?
Oh my god. Calm the fuck down, dude.
It's your pal, Bigby.
Hi, Bigby. Please excuse us for just a minute. Can I talk to you in private?
Yes, let's.
Dude, look at the picture in the back there.
I guess I really do have the smallest apartment in the Woodlands.
Look at him.
Talk about living in the past.
There they are.
Not after the way he went behind my back.
Oh my god.
And then you run and call him again?
Well, I trust him.
Of course you do. He was keeping.
Why was he just knocking on that?
It was one little thing.
No, like they fucking. Oh, he's flipping out.
Try to sort this out.
All I'm saying is we can handle this on our own. We didn't have to bring him here.
We're out of money. And answers.
Bigby, like, it's just. Bigby is a good guy. Bigby just wants to help. Like, that's it.
Fine. If you want to talk, we'll talk.
So there's a knock. Hello.
Thanks for letting us finish our conversation.
Sorry, it's been a long night.
Yeah, you know what they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta
damn right.
Say, your place? It looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
Beast!
No, really, I wanna
oh
know.
Oh my god.
What are you trying to say, huh?
Nothing. It's a nice place you got here.
Thanks, but that's really not why I called.
Is this something about that loan you took out? From the crooked man?
Cool.
I didn't know what else to do, so...
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to complicate
it.
I mean, maybe.
Here, and I want to see if he can help us out. Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us.
I'd like to help you, but I can't do anything if you don't tell me what's going on.
I mean, shit might hit the fan faster, but...
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the crooked man? What if we talk and you don't get it? And all this comes back on us.
Oh my god,
we'd be risking
dude.
A lot. We've seen what happens when you cross the crooked man. And I don't know if it's worth it.
I can protect you, but only if you tell me
beast,
what
you,
I need
beast,
to know.
You can fucking protect.
And that means
you can protect her, you're a fucking beast, man.
We aren't.
And just tell me what's going on here.
Beast can handle
Look,
it himself.
We're used to a certain kind of lifestyle.
Well, shit.
We couldn't just give that
we
up.
We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn. And we got in over our heads.
There's not
there
a lot
go.
Of work out there. Who would we be if we just lived like...
Oh, I wonder who that could be. Hmm.
Let me just,
A day at the beach?
Skiing the slopes?
And
can we
can't
finish this conversation
right
first?
Now.
I
Leave
should
a
get
message
that.
At the Come beach on. And we'll get back to you as soon as... humanly possible.
Uh-oh.
That fucking message. I'm gonna come down there and bash your heads in with that machine if I have to call again and hear that fucking message one more time.
Ooh.
I've been doing this long enough to know that if you had the cash, you'd have paid by now. So consider yourselves out of warnings. It's time to start thinking about how else you can settle this. Because next time, I'm making a house call.
Who is that?
Oh my god.
The crooked man's gonna get his, one way or another.
Oh my god. That doesn't sound good at all.
All I care about
That's fucking
is
very
how
threatening.
Can I find the crooked man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
Just fucking tell me, boyos. I'm here to help you. I don't want you to get fucking crookified.
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The crooked man's behind that place.
Okay.
That I'd overheard sense. People talking to Jersey about loans before. So, when I needed money, that's where I went. I didn't know
Wait
what
a minute.
To do.
You could have told me.
You had enough on your plate.
Who gets
who's Jersey?
Lunch
That's the real
anyway.
Question.
What's really going on at this place?
The crooked man knows what people need to get by, so he provides. Besides, it didn't seem like such a bad deal when Jersey Devil was
Ah, Jersey Devil.
I can can see now that it was a mistake, but I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day.
Oh, sure, really?
It was in a display case.
Wait.
I guess he's hit hard times, too. There's a lot of that going around.
Yeah, that's where Mary got it from.
Bloody Mary must go through there. She had Woody's axe last night. Tried to chop my damn head off with it.
Maybe if you go there, you can sort some things out.
Yeah, I imagine, okay.
I guess I'll go check out the lucky pawn. If track down the crooked man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the crooked man will come find me.
I don't know.
Hold on, don't go there. Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble.
Yeah, I don't know if I should do that. The more trouble I cause, the more chance I get killed.
It's the place on Tubman Street. Same block as the baker and the candlestick maker.
Okay.
Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the crooked man.
Oh.
And I don't think it's meat in the packages. You gotta understand, I needed work.
You have to believe us.
Listen to me very carefully. Did you ever deliver to the crooked man? Can you give me an address?
No. I delivered to places all over town, but never to the man himself. He never seems to be heading to the same place, but it always comes out of the butcher shop.
That's weird.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me.
Oh.
She said I was reliable. She liked that. And it's the only thing I've been able to pick up. And it's still not enough. I don't want Beauty to have to work, especially not where she was.
Oh my
Mary
god.
To deal with? Bloody Mary is there?
No, Johann is the one who hands over the packages, you know, day to day. But I've seen her around there. She gets under my skin, you know, and I try to avoid her. But I don't need to tell you what she's
You're
like.
Damn right you don't. I don't need a rundown on her reputation.
That's fucking weird.
Mary works out of there. I need to look into it.
I just wanted to provide for Beauty. Give her the
fucking get it, but still. We're not in fucking Fable Town. We're in fucking New York. You gotta fucking work.
None of us should. We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle.
Yep.
All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home. You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
No, I fucking wouldn't understand.
I don't need to understand. It's not my fucking job to understand. My job is to keep Fable Town
safe. Fucking damn right.
So, where are you going?
No, I don't know.
If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from.
Fuck, I was gonna make these hard decisions of where I'm gonna go. Fuck. I feel like, okay, if I go to the Lucky Pawn, I'll run into Jersey
Lucky
Devil.
Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The
and now probably get place. Them in trouble, maybe. Not to mention, I'll probably have to fight the Jersey Devil or fucking I'll turn into a shitstorm. But if we go to the
butcher shop, the cut above.
Johann's there, he's a cool guy, obviously.
I don't think it's meat in the packages. You know that butcher shop, the cut above.
And Bloody Mary might be there.
The thing is, I don't think it's meat in the packages.
Fuck.
You know that butcher shop, the cut above.
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money.
But she just borrowed money from them, and...
The crooked man's behind them.
You know that butcher shop?
Let's go to the butcher shop. He's behind fucking both of them anyway.
At that butcher shop.
But yeah, the packages
you
would
know,
be nice to know what's in
up
there.
There. Word is gonna spread. There may be nothing left for you to see if you go to the Lucky Pawn after.
Well, I guess I'll find out.
Fuck it, let's see what happens.
Wait. I don't know what you're planning to do when you find the crooked man.
You're gonna fucking kick its ass.
Is there any way you could help us out?
Oh my god.
Well, maybe you can make this all just go away.
We would really appreciate it. What do you say?
Can you help us out?
You're asking me to kill him, aren't you?
Exactly.
Is that what you think I do?
No, of course not.
I don't
how the fuck do you think I'm gonna
idea?
Make...
We know that the Crooked Man is dangerous to all of Fable Town.
So how the fuck do you want me to
do my
like,
job? Lucky for you, that might just solve your problems anyway.
Oh, thank you, Bigby.
Yeah, what are you expecting to do?
The right thing.
You want me to fucking get your fucking money back, which you fucking shouldn't have been fucking spending it to get into that luxurious fucking apartment. You should have just bought fucking cheap things, normal things like fucking everyone else does. Like, sorry, that's not my fucking problem. You guys were, oh, we're royalty. Well, we live in fucking New York now, so you gotta fucking do your fucking due diligence and fucking work like everybody else. Let's just fucking go along. Just so we don't cause any issues. What do we got here? Cold drinks. Nice, got some lemon lime, some cola, some more lemon lime. What do we got on the board here? Interesting. Huh. I guess I'll take a number.
Either he's got a whole lot of customers, or he doesn't have any.
I want to take a number anyway and fucking, you know, just wait. Okay. This frozen meat looks fucking like...
very appetizing.
Very, like...
frozen solid.
Yeah, honestly, it looks like a fucking freezer burned. Interesting. Let's hit the bell, see what happens. Hello? Ayo!
Bigby Wolf?
His face!
Well, welcome, Sheriff. What can I get for you? You interested in a particular cut?
See, look at you, he's so fucking nervous already.
What do we have in stock? Let's see what we got here. Flank steak, on special. New York strip. I can have some wild boar in tomorrow if you like. Sirloin, ribs.
Johan, I want to know exactly
he already knows what's
going on
here.
We sell meat. Did you want to buy something?
Stuff looks like it's been in the fucking freezer for like 30 generations of fucking...
what you see is...
of your fucking family.
Just meat. Don't find anything else. We just, we do more wholesale and meat packing than walk-up service. I'd like to help you. Really, I would. But there's nothing here.
So you don't mind if I take a look around?
I guess not.
Nah.
Sheriff, I...
why are you so anxious?
Did you hear that?
What?
Oh, I'm real
sorry. What the fuck did he do?
I just gotta go check on that.
He hit that fucking button.
Anywhere. I'll be right back.
Butcher?
I just have to go see.
What does that fucking button do? What does that button do? Oh-ho.
Shit.
What the fuck, dude? Oh, shit. Oh, a meat dude.
I got it covered back here, Sheriff. I'll be right out.
What the fuck, dude? What the fuck? I'm not gonna say anything, just so he doesn't know I'm here. There's so much meat back here, so what the fuck's going on?
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but you're not supposed to be back here for safety purposes.
Yeah, there's all this fucking meat in the way. Is that fucking why? I'm gonna stay quiet. They always said being quiet is a valid answer.
Oh, you gotta be kidding.
Oh.
You're gonna kill me. Oh god, she is gonna fucking kill me.
What is he doing?
He's gonna get me killed. Things I do.
I scared the shit out of you, didn't I?
Please, Bigby, please don't.
Bigby, what happened to Sheriff?
Ooh.
Please don't kill me, Sheriff.
I might kill you.
Please, please don't kill me. Please don't kill me.
If you don't talk, I might have to do just that. Is that what you want, Johan?
No, please. You don't have to do that. I'm dead. Either way, they said to me,
Johan, you could keep your life and lose your shop, or lose both. What would you do? It was a simple choice to make in the moment. Easy, even when they got you on a hook in the deep freeze.
Why are you trying to sneak out the back, Johan? What are you afraid of?
That whole crew.
Crew?
The Crooked Man's people. Jersey Devil, D and Dumb, and that mental case Bloody
Well, one Mary. Of them is dead.
You want to talk about the real butcher? It's her, not me. This is her place. I'm telling you, they muscled in on me. Took over my storage and delivery a long time ago.
Okay.
All cause of that heat wave. That summer was even hotter than this one. Oh, I let Mary and those porkers stay cool in the meat locker one day, playing cards, having a great time. I guess they were sizing the place up. Shows what I get for being nice. I'm just a victim in this. I don't know what they do back there. I swear. And I don't want to know.
You're definitely fucking lying. You know what fucking happens.
Why the fuck should I believe you now?
Because it's the truth. I knew this would happen. Didn't know. Shh.
The fuck is what's behind this door, dude? What's behind this fucking door? What are you hiding, Johan? Johan the Bitcher? What? What? There's like a meth lab back here? Dude. They're fucking cooking meth back here. What's going on? I wanted some. Stock. What the fuck? Black forest soil? Nosebleed? People were chained up here? There's blood?
What is this place?
I told you, Bigby. I don't know. They muscled me out. I swear, I don't know anything more. I haven't been back here when it was like this.
What the fuck?
Warning lights.
And he hit. That's what the switch did.
It's all I've ever had. I guess that's why I stuck around when they took it.
You hit the fucking button, and that's what it did.
Into this, and then turn around and help them.
You asshole.
Still be here if you hadn't flipped that switch out there.
I had to. You come in here making trouble for me, but you only give a shit now because the Crooked Man stepped on your toes or something. Where were you when they took this place from me? It hasn't been easy for me. You think
Christ.
I want to live with this at my back? I needed help.
Fucking shut
You're
up,
not man. Off the fucking hook yet, Butcher. If I find something, if I so much as smell something that makes me think you're lying.
What a fuck! Like, look at this. Everything's right here. Illegal glamours. That's what they're doing back here.
So this is what Beast was delivering. Glamours. Other kinds of magic.
Oh my god.
Dangerous stuff.
What the fuck, dude?
What are they making here?
I'm just a butcher. You want to talk T-bones? That I can do. This stuff is out of my league.
Tongue of dog.
There are a lot of nasty spells you can make with the right equipment.
What the fuck? Now, who is shackled up?
Who's getting chained up here?
You can't think I'm the only one the Crooked Man has under his yoke.
It's fucking blood. Is it other fables, I assume? What the fuck? This is fucked up, dude.
That's simple. It's on all the packages. What is it?
That's the Crooked Man's, brand. It's on everything that goes in and out of here.
So you do know something.
Yeah, exactly.
Huh? Is that a wheel or what?
I guess they never used that thing on wolves, huh?
What's that supposed to mean?
It's from back in the homelands. A torture device. It came over here with the rest of our stories. Not that Bundys need any help coming up with that kind of thing. It makes people crooked. Like breaking their bones and...
Uh-huh.
Do I really need to explain this?
Yeah, you fucking do. Because you're a fucking prick. What is this?
Huh.
Stocks and
like
supply.
Math or something.
Oh, what's behind this? Another board? Oh!
Shit. Is everybody on here?
Wow, what the fuck?
You know anything about this?
I don't know.
Those are the potions to make them to look like certain people. Maybe.
Don't you see what's going on here? All these fables, magic from him. Business is booming.
Or maybe those are the customers.
The gear. Slave labor to work it. So these must be the raw materials.
Mm-hmm.
Wonder he needs so much.
Oh yeah? Why?
Doing it like this. It's bound to be cheaper than the 13th floor.
This is just horrible. Things that must have gone on here.
It's the pudding and pie girls with the ribbons. Whoever he's got in here in these chains, he's enslaving fables.
Yeah, buddy, it's fucking... He's a fucking...
People just don't know the real cost of getting something cheap.
You don't have to tell me.
It's fucking sick. This sick
fucker.
Fuck.
Crane knew all about it.
Yeah, what about Crane? This all... I mean, finding the crooked man is so fucking important. Why don't you ask your boss?
Snow.
No, Crane. He said he knows where everybody is. I don't know how, but he's got some way. That's right. It was that creepy
the
mirror.
Mirror
with the big green head and all. Why don't you just use that? Find the crooked man that way. Leave me alone.
Because the mirror's fucking broken, because
yeah,
Crane took the piece.
Stuff like that mirror, I'm surprised that you ever need to leave the office.
Crane shattered the mirror and made off with one of the pieces.
Yeah.
Probably still has the shard with him.
They knew what the fuck
well,
he was doing.
If they got their hands on an important magical item, there's only one place they'd take it. The Lucky Pawn. They probably took Crane there, too.
The Lucky Pawn.
Hmm.
If I can find the mirror piece there, I can find the Crooked Man.
Hey, hold on.
What the fuck
well,
do you want, Johan?
I'm real happy you found what you're looking for, Bigby. What about me? Huh? What the hell am I supposed to do now?
You fucking lied to me,
I'm
you prick.
I'm gonna have to spend the rest of my short life looking over my shoulder for Bloody Mary. They won't care.
Hey, you're on your fucking own, buddy. You fucking lied. You knew what was going on here.
I'd run.
Yep. You're fucked, Johan. You are fucked. You fucking asshole. We could have got who was ever back there. And we still gotta fucking go here anyway.
Don't give me that shit. What the fuck is the point of having a system if you're just
Except
gonna...
my fucking
Jack.
System.
Jack.
What the fuck is going on?
But you,
I'm,
you're the guy who
just gonna...
Sure.
I'm the guy to keep shit in.
Yeah.
And that's it, Woody. If you love your ex so fucking much, why'd you pawn it in the first fucking place, huh?
Oh.
I didn't pawn it, asshole. It was stolen from my apartment.
You don't want no...
Yeah, why would
so
Woody pawn his ass?
Hit bricks. See you later.
Oh
hey,
my god.
What's going on here?
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
And this fucking guy too?
Are you kidding me? It was here. It was right fucking here. What did you do with it?
Bloody Mary has it.
Listen, you bald little dipshit. You're gonna...
Bloody Mary has the fucking thing. Oh.
Cool it, Woody.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you. We don't need the business office involved in this shit. I just want what's mine. My axe.
Will you get out of here? Go home.
Not until this fucker gives me my axe.
He doesn't have it.
How you feeling today, Sheriff?
Okay.
Still looking for whoever killed them hookers? Or are you done chasing your tail?
Oh my god. Yeah, there you go.
Where's my axe?
Woody, calm down. Woody, calm down. Woody, calm down.
This is my fucking fight.
Calm down, Woody.
Now, dog, you got a lot of nerve.
Oh my god, look what you fucking did. Oh, great. Triple threat, man. Triple threat. This is what I didn't want to happen. Oh my god. Jesus, this guy just stopped fucking fighting. Holy shit. Oh, what's in- oh, there's a- oh, there it is!
Too bad you couldn't protect those whores!
It's right in the fuck, it's right behind him!
Try to stop me!
Fuck, you prick. Asshole. Yeah.
There she is!
Oh, this is gonna fucking hurt. Oh my god! Fuck him! Oh no! Oh fuck. No. Hit him. Fucking prick. Hit him again. Oh. Fucking prompt. What the fuck? Woody, help. Woody, help. Please. Oh. You ripped his fucking antler. Oh. And he stabbed him with his own antler. Damn, dude. Woody, get him. Jump like that. Oh, here we go. Woody, hit him. Woody, where are you? Get him, Woody, get him. Woody, what are you doing over there? Hit him with the axe.
Hey, asshole.
Here we go.
I found her.
Oh, right in the head. Right in the fucking head, dude. Oh, the fucking asshole, the anvil at him. Fuck him. Okay, that didn't fucking kill him. I don't know what's going to. Holy shit. Hit him over there with an anvil. Oh, and he's pulling out of his head. Ah. Fucking do it. Why not?
The magic mirror's missing shard. Where is it? Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
You don't know anything about anything, do you?
What do you have?
Nothing. That useless bitch Snow White in a broken fucking mirror. No fucking friends.
Where's the crooked man? How can I find him?
You can't find a crooked man. No one can.
What?
Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot.
Okay.
You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror. They dumped all his shit here. Bloody Mary uses this place like a fucking dump.
Where's Crane's stuff? Where'd they put it?
In back.
Okay. That's in the closet there. Okay, with that book.
Just go on. Get Crane's shit and go. Not that it's gonna do you any good.
See anything?
Crane's coat.
A lot of pockets, though. Ooh.
Time for traveler's checks, huh?
Fuck, do I leave it?
He won't be needing this anymore.
I ain't gonna take the money. Fuck it. Maybe I can give some of it to
Beast. Sick piece of...
Maybe I can give it to Beast and Beauty.
The shard.
There it is.
It's the shard.
It's a lot smaller than... Finally. A lot smaller than it was. In the mirror. Thanks, Woody.
Hey, Sheriff.
Uh-oh.
Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you could do to bring them back.
Okay.
And I don't know what they did. But I do know this. Oh, if they're dead, it's because the crooked man wanted them dead.
Oh.
That's all it takes. So you can roar smash the place up. Shit. You can wail on me all you want. But what good is it gonna do you? Because he ain't in your town. You're in his. And he sure as shit is ready for you.
Okay. The crooked man is a bitch. The people that he has surrounding him are the ones, you know, defending him. He, otherwise, he can fucking just punch him in the fucking head and he's dead. Like,
don't take much.
Look at me and Woody fucking smoking some.
Shitty brand.
The Huff and Puffs.
You're welcome. I'm not gonna lie, I was having trouble deciding which one of you to hit with this thing.
Hey, we're buds, man. We're best buds. You don't need to lose your shit on me.
Jersey was wrong, you know.
About what?
About those girls. There is something you can do about it. You can get the fucker who did it. Ain't that the
That's
plan?
True.
Yeah, you're damn right it is.
Yeah.
All right, go do it then.
Just walks away. Oh fuck, the pawn shop is right beside the trip shop. I was realizing that.
Hey Woody.
Yeah.
I saw the staircase going down. I was like,
gonna be all right.
Trip shop here isn't too.
You know me.
Just walking around with it, that's funny. This taxi driver kind of looks like Dr. Swinehart, but like a younger version. Oh my god, dude. So the fucking Crooked Man is in his own world, and the door, or the entrance to it, goes around town and disappears and shows up different places.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes. Crane was helping himself to the community coffers. It means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get the word in. Now, Miss Ward,
damn it,
I think Bigby has returned. Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
You will have to wait. Just one
Toad,
moment,
you're gonna get
a
smack
please.
Upside the head if you keep on fucking blabbering. Yeah, buddy.
Your dog wants a biscuit.
Hey, okay, you Bluebeard.
Buffkin, get this.
You want to be throwing shit
right
at me?
Away.
You need to be fucking throwing shade at me for no reason.
Finally, things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day.
Thank you.
What did you uncover? I thought you were going to report
Lots.
Back to me. I mean, it's fine. So what else did you find out?
I had to get real persuasive with the Jersey Devil, the lucky pawn, but he told me that the Crooked Man's door, to wherever it is he hangs his hat, it moves. It's some kind of magic door.
Do you think the mirror will be able to find the door, once it's fixed?
That's yes. How Crane did it. That's how we're gonna do it.
Excellent work. Really.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Okay. It's not like you can't fucking reach it because you
Don't
fucking
far,
fly out.
Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
I'm
Fuck off until I'm ready. Take
oh,
a number.
Yeah? Take a number.
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
I was gonna say, it doesn't look like it's the right. Like, it doesn't look like it's big enough.
Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know. So this process can be a little touchy.
Crane was carrying it.
Yeah.
Part of the night, at least. I found it in his coat. It's pretty amazing it's still intact after the fight, the kidnapping, and then riding around with Bloody Mary for an hour.
Yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other.
Oh.
How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
That's
well,
true.
I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help.
That makes sense.
It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Buffkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
These two idiots.
If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business officer?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now.
Can I?
We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're
fucking babbling around like fucking children
about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
Look at their fucking idiots. Look at them. Look at Toad.
You need some help over there?
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him.
I mean, I have some
he
extra
really
money.
He needs to go to the farm, you know. So just break the news and be done with it, okay?
That's true. That is true. He does have to go to the farm. Why doesn't he glamour himself? I don't. Well, I guess he can't afford it, but still. If anyone else can glamour, why can't he, right?
I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh? Why am I not surprised? Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is. Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallet because of you.
Toad, this is the business office.
I know. Toad, you gotta go.
You're always talking about glamours and how it's my responsibility. Well, what about your responsibility? My car, total, the gaping mall in my wall, any of us sound familiar? I'm not looking for a handout, just what's right.
I need it, Big B. I gotta write the checks around here, but I know I had a hand in it, so I'll try to get Snow to take it.
We will try, Toad. We will try and make things better for you.
It's the only way I'll be able to get me glamours.
Yeah, yes. All right. But, this isn't exactly a new problem with you. You know that if you're out of glamour, I gotta send you to the farm.
Well, how about your friend the pig? Is he going to the farm too? Yeah, you thought we didn't know about him, huh? A worst kept secret in fable times. For a friend, the rules will bend. That's a slippery slope, that is.
I haven't decided on him yet. Yeah. Every situation's different, Toad.
He stays in the apartment, so he doesn't cause problems like you do, Toad.
And me boy, too. If you give me one more chance and hear me out, I'll see a way for me and me boy to stay. I'm not going to ask for any more than I need. I just want to stay. So what do you say? You just give me enough to cover me glamours and we'll call the rest to watch. Please, Sheriff. Don't take TJ from the only army knows. This old glamour rule is oppressive. I've done nothing wrong, but look different.
Look,
we'll work something out.
I'll try to get you that money and get you another chance, but you have to understand, it's not entirely up to me.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Sheriff. I knew I could count on you to make me whole again. We get this sorted, and I'll be glamour to the nines, I will.
Look at him. The most I've seen Toad move ever. Look how happy he is.
Bluebeard, you want to talk?
Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean,
yes.
I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now. But glamours are the law for a very good reason. You know that as well as anyone.
Don't worry. I did the right thing.
Are you sure? Because he left looking pretty happy. Fine. We'll deal with it later. I know I should be asking how it got like this. But I just keep wondering why it happened. To Faith and Lily.
You've seen his
world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with his own hand, or if it was one of his goons, but someone did.
If it is about control. Figured out, it's that the Crooked Man is all about control. It's what he does with the loans at the pawn shop, the magic he peddles, chains, ribbons. Maybe Faith and Lily weren't doing what they were told, or maybe they just tried to leave.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is
repaired. Hey, Buffkin, you did it.
I have to say, I have been better. But thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry, I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep.
Perfect.
Yeah, I want to see where he's ended up, too.
His jacket's in the pawn shop, so where the fuck is he?
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep.
What?
Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute.
What?
Someone's watching.
Uh-oh. What?
What just happened?
We pointed you in the wrong direction. And looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her.
That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again.
Okay?
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right. We need to focus on the immediate threat.
Damn right.
And that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Are you having trouble with the rhyme, Sheriff?
Mirror, mirror. No time to pout. So, where does Crooked Man hang out?
Heyo.
I don't recognize the door, but...
Where's that? The symbol, yes.
Crooked Man's symbol on it.
Hold on.
Oh, it's moving. What fucking... What?
The door. It moves.
Yeah, it moves. That's what I was telling you, so...
Wait a minute.
So where is it? Central Park.
I don't know when it's going to move again, but I'm going to get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. This can't be like it was with Tweedledum. I don't care if it gets out of hand. You don't let it come to that.
Okay.
I know that emotions can run high. And you have your reasons to handle this a certain way.
I'll
bring him back.
Bring him back here. Alive. And we can clean him and cook him together.
Good. I have enough to worry about here while
I will try to. I should have said no promises.
So I'm going
no
to
promises.
Trust you to handle this properly.
Should have said that. Oh my god.
If you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice.
I should have told her no promises instead of saying yeah I will, because I'm going to probably end up fucking murdering him because I just feel like murdering him. And then she can be like, you didn't fucking bring him back alive. What the fuck is your problem? Well, here we are. Central Park, 94th Street. The Gothic Bridge. He's fucking running, dude. Imagine how fast he runs. There it is. Let's fucking go.
That's it, alright.
I'm not gonna kick it open. It just seems very, immature. What the fuck, dude? Lost cat. Okay, here we go. Woo! Woo! Oh. Oh, and it's gone now. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Who the fuck is that, dude? Oh, what the... What? Oh, it's...
Tim!
What the... Tim the Two-Man Taylor.
Good evening, Sheriff. I'm here to take you to the boss. Thanks, by the way. For leaving off Tiny Tim.
What the fuck?
I have to admit,
Tiny
when they
Tim
asked me to watch the door, I wasn't sure what to expect when you came through that portal. I know you aren't here on a social call.
Hold on.
What the fuck?
You've just been waiting for me to show up? You knew I was coming?
That's what they told me. I don't know, they said you made it pretty clear.
Oh.
I'm
okay.
I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so... If you'll come this way. Look, this is the one thing I have to do.
Fine.
Okay, we won't make your life hard because you're already fucking suffering enough, Tiny Tim. We'll make it easy for you. Fucking look at this guy.
Thanks for understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up. I know I'm probably the last person you'd expect to be a guard. Or an escort, for that matter. I was a little surprised myself when they asked me to do it.
Tim, how can you be working here? You know who this guy is, don't you?
He's not as bad as you think.
Okay.
He doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like. He gave me a job. And I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got. Just keep that in mind, maybe? Because if you and the boss go up against each other, the rest of Fable Town is going to get caught in the
middle. Yeah, but yeah, it's true. You are part of this,
you're
though.
Not just minding the door. Work for that crooked bastard, your hands get dirty.
Damn
too.
Right.
It's not so bad.
You're involved.
Are you fucking blind, Tim? He's a murderer.
So you're telling me you agree with everything Crane does?
No. Fuck no, I don't.
A lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office. But he's there. We need you. But
yeah,
we
but
need him too.
He gives you money and whatever you need, and then in return, you have to fucking work for him.
I gotta go in with you.
You have to fucking work for him, or you have to pay him back. If not, they fucking kill you. Like, it's not a good person.
What did I tell you? Stop laughing at me.
Go ahead. You got a job to do.
I ain't scared.
Jesus Christ, dude.
Sheriff Wolf, sir.
Heyo. Georgie. George, the fuck? Come the fuck down, Jersey.
I know the sheriff isn't the accommodating
but you helped. Oh my god.
You did well. You can go now.
Ew.
Thank you, sir.
What's wrong with his fucking eye? What happened? Why is it fucking like halfway down his face?
Everyone in Fabletown has a role to fill. You just have to pay attention to what they need to help them find it.
Okay. Yeah, shut you fucking three fools.
Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
I guess we fucking do. Fucking smoke, fuck it. His face, dude. Oh, shit. That was an epic cutaway. Damn, dude. Shit's gonna get real soon. Next time on The Wolf Among Us. That just seemed like a perfect
ending. I've heard stories about you.
Oh, God.
Oh, in the old days, I picked out those men one by one. Oh, I screamed. The wolf is coming. And they would wait. Hiding anywhere they could squeeze their pathetic, shivering corpses. Some would just drop to their knees where they stood, close their eyes, and wait for death.
Oh, shit.
And you'd give it to them.
Ho, ho, ho.
I wish I could have seen it.
She's fucking sick and deranged.
Oh, well.
Oh, jeez. We're gonna fight Bloody Mary. Holy shit, dude. Oh. Okay, here we go. Through the fucking choices, dude. Did you send Colin to the farm? You and 85.5% of players decided Colin should not go to the farm. Well, if Colin's not gonna go to the farm, then we're gonna make it fair enough for anyone else, like Toad or whatever, and no one should go to the farm. So Or you send them all there, but at the same time, Colin's been fucking pretty good. Toad's been an asshole, but he's understanding. But anyway, did you attempt to remove Rhaenyra's ribbon? You and 63.8% of players did not try to remove the ribbon. If you had tried to remove the ribbon, I don't know what the fuck would have happened. She probably would have panicked even more. It was like, fuck yeah, you asshole. Anyway, which crooked operation did you investigate first? You and 63.2% of players went to the cut above first. Well, yeah, because there's fucking something being packaged up there that you don't even know what it is until you get there, and it's the fucking glamorous. And then, did you send Toad to the farm? You and 73.3% of players decided Toad should not go to the farm, which I was only found, like I said, only fair that, you know, he's been causing trouble and fucking commotions and this and that. I did fucking destroy his car and his fucking place that he was renting out and everything. So, and also, I didn't send Colin, and so fair enough, I don't send him either. Anyway, and then how did you respond to the crooked band? You and 43.7% of players lit a cigarette. I thought I just did it because it was like a fucking badass way of doing it. And yeah, so we're all done. I actually finished that a lot, you know, quicker than I thought. But without further ado, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, I hope you've been enjoying this series for the first time, or, you know, multiple times, I don't know, this is my second time playing it. Some things do kind of like, I do remember the things, and then a lot of the story I don't remember, because the last time I played this was when it came out, back in 2014, I think, so, it's kind of like it's a refresher for the new Wolf Among Us 2 coming out next year sometime. So that's why I wanted to do this. But I also love the game as well, so that was the other reason. So I was looking forward to this. But without further ado, thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in. And we'll see you in the fifth and final episode of The Wolf Among Us. Bye!